This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a classic retro 1940s horror movie title design. I provided a Photoshop template for you to download. It includes this dramatically lighted Gothic castle staircase, the top and bottom text, and two layers of film scratches. The template's link is in my video's description or project files. When you first click the link, you'll probably see just one layer of the film scratches. However, when you open it in Photoshop, you'll see all the layers. I also included a custom fog brush, as well as the title font called Abaddon 2. Feel free to use any font you like. Hide the top three layers and make the background active. We'll make a new layer above it by clicking the New Layer icon. In this layer, we'll add foggy mist. Let's name it Fog Mist. Open your brush tool and check your foreground and background colors. We want white to be our foreground color since that's the color we want on our brush. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard. Reverse the colors by pressing X. After you install the fog brush I provided, open the brush picker and scroll to the bottom of the list. Open the fog brush folder and click the thumbnail, then press Enter or Return. The opacity and flow are both 100%. Place your cursor at the bottom middle of the image and click once. Make layer 1 visible and the top film scratches as well. Make it active and change its blend mode to multiply. Make the film scratches under it visible and active. We'll invert it by pressing Ctrl or Command I. Change its blend mode to lighter color. Make layer 1 active and make a new layer above it. In this layer, we'll create the title of our movie. Open your horizontal type tool and click the foreground color to open the color picker. Make the brightness 80%, which gives us a light gray color. Click on your document. Open the type picker and pick a font. If you want to use the same font I'm using, after you install it from the link I provided, type into the text field Abaddon. I'll start with a size of 320 points. However, feel free to adjust its size based on the font you pick and the number of characters in your text. The aliasing is smooth and center alignment. Type out your text. We can adjust the size of each word and each character, as well as the spacing between the lines of text called leading, and all the characters called tracking. To do this, click the character paragraph icon or go to Window and Character. This opens the character paragraph windows. If you want to reduce or enlarge the size of a word, highlight it, and in the character window, either type in the size or place your cursor over the size icon. When it changes into a scrubby slider, drag it to the left or right. To lower or raise the word, place your cursor over the baseline shift icon and drag it to the left or right. To move the word to the left or right, place your cursor to the left of the first character and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. Use these steps to finesse your title. Open your Move tool and drag it to the center. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Next, we'll warp its shape. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. Open the warp presets and feel free to check how each one warps your text. I'll click Rise. To adjust its bend direction, place your cursor over the word bend and drag it to the right or left. Drag it to the center. Then press Enter or Return. Click an empty area of the layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. Pause the video so you can copy these settings. Click Contour and open the contour presets. If you don't see the name of the contour next to its thumbnail, click the gear icon and click either the small or large list. Click Ring. Next, we'll add a solid drop shadow. Control or Command click the title to select its shape. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by Control or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill the selection with black by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open the Fill window. Open the Contents list and click Black. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. We'll place our black text into a folder since we'll be creating dozens of copies of it to create the solid drop shadow. Press Ctrl or Command G. Make the black text active and open your Transform tool. At the top in the Angle field, type in 45. This will angle our black text 45 degrees. Press Enter or Return twice. We'll make multiple copies of it that will move it down one pixel at a time. To do this, press Alt or Option and the down arrow until there's approximately between 80 to 90 copies. Make the folder active and open back your Transform tool. Type into the Angle field minus 45. This rotates our black text back to its original angle. With your Move tool, drag the solid black drop shadow so it lines up with your title. Let's close the folder to save space in the Layers panel. We'll convert our text and the solid drop shadow into one smart object. Shift-click the title layer to make it active as well, and convert them both into one smart object. Go to Filter, Blur, and Blur More. This filter is 4 times more powerful than just the blur filter. It blurs our title just enough to match the softness of the rest of our image. Lastly, I'll show you how to adjust your title's size and aspect ratio. Open your Transform tool. If you see this message, it's just letting us know that the blur filter will be temporarily turned off until we're done with the Transform tool. Click OK or press Enter or Return. Go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag it out or in. To stretch or compress it, go to either side's anchor point or the top or bottom anchors and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.